This is gorgeous. I am so excited. If you don't know who I am, I'll tell you one more time who I am. I'm Mrs. Arnold, the principal of this wonderful school, and I am so pleased that you're here tonight. We thank you for sharing your children, your grandchildren, your neighbor's kids. I don't know who you're here for, but you know, it doesn't matter that you're here, and we have a wonderful play for you. You know, God's good all the time. Even when we don't think he's working out the things the way we want them worked out, he's good because he's perfect in every way. He knows what's best for us. He knows the beginning to the end and everything in between. Sometimes when I give my testimony, and I'm not going to give it tonight, so don't worry. I gave it, and I said, you know, sometimes I skip alongside God. You know, I'm walking with you. It's going good, and sometimes I'm way ahead, and he says, all right, Arnold, come back here with me. And sometimes he has to drag me along, but he never gives up on me. And that's just like it is for you. We're so happy you're here. I just have a few things to say. I'm just so pleased that I have this privilege of being the principal of these wonderful 106 students. That's good. That's a small group then compared to what I've had before. And I am so pleased to be the principal for about 28 staff members, maybe 30. I lose count every once in a while. That means the whole, it's not just the teachers. It's our custodians, our secretary. It's our, you know, our preschool. It's our SAC. And I am just so blessed to be their principal. And they just bless me every day. Miss Anita, would you stand up, please? I wanted to start this evening off just right. She always does. I've known Miss Anita, not personally, but for a lot of years, and she's always been so talented, and she has brought out the talent in these boys and girls. And it couldn't be done without her leadership. She's the one that planned. She's the one that says, you will do this. Here's this microphone, but you put it back on the blue table when you're done. I'm not a stand-up comic, but that's okay. But she's the ramrod of this production. Ramrod. The head honcho. The big kahuna. You know, I had one of my teachers that called me that, Miss Anita. That's a compliment. So anyway, and the teachers and the staff, would you all kind of just stand up? If you're sitting, stand up. Teachers, staff, Susan, Dave. None of this would be possible without them. And if you weren't here this afternoon for our dress rehearsal, two words, dress rehearsal, our preschoolers were in here. They were adorable. And they sang about four little songs, and they just added to the program. But I'm so sorry. We didn't have room for tonight, but they were here. And we just thank Miss Peggy and whatever your name is, Miss Jackie, for working with them. I'm not going to talk anymore because I know that you're wanting to see the kids and not me, and I'm going to ask Pastor Claude to come out and lead us in prayer, and then after that, the bossy woman's going to take over with the microphone on the blue table.
Wow, you are windier than I am. I tell you what. I was going to preach about 45 minutes. We're just going to pray, okay? Hey, I want to take some pictures. This is awesome. Look at this. Oh, yeah. This is what preachers don't get to do very often. I always wanted to do this. Everybody just raise your hands up like you got the Holy Spirit, you know? Oh, yeah. Oh, Church at GCC. Praise the Lord. Hey, really, it is good to have all of you here. We love the kids. We love the teachers. We're so glad you came out tonight. You know this is going to be awesome, but you know this. This is all about our precious baby Jesus that is our Savior. Amen. Let me pray with you. I'm going to get out of the way because I know what you came for. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you so much. We thank you for each and every child. We thank you for their parents. And God, we give praise for the teachers and God, our administration. And Lord, tonight, we just pray this, that Father, you are honored, that you're honored by this wonderful performance. It's all about loving our Lord and Savior because you loved us so much. God, thank you again for New Horizon Christian School. We thank you for what's going to take place tonight. God, we believe upon the name of Jesus, and we ask this in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Everybody say it amen, all right? Amen.
We are coming to you live from the Christmas County Spelling Bee, which will begin at Town Hall shortly.
It will be followed with the annual live mini contest.
The streets are lined with lights and twinkling Christmas trees. The town is all abuzz, a buzzing for the bee. With family and friends, it's really quite a sight.
I'm Pat Paycheck, along with Vanna Black, your commentators for this evening.
There's wonder in the air, excitement all around. The annual tradition is coming back to town. We'll be the champion and spell each word just right. The Christmas County Spelling Bee is finally here tonight.
I'm Judge Thomas, and welcome to the Bee.
That's how the points are earned. The origins from which they came and the definition will help us learn our Savior's name through this competition.
Now, does everyone know the rules?
This year at our spelling bee, everyone will learn to spell the names of Jesus. That's how the points are earned. The origins from which they came and their definitions will help us learn our Savior's name.
What an exciting time of year, Christmas, and we are here to celebrate the true reason for this season, Jesus. That's why we have begun a tradition that we have an annual live manger scene at Town Hall. So many of you want to participate in the pageant. The way we have selected to choose our cast is through this spelling bee competition. You see, nobody loses in this bee. Everyone participating will get a part in the pageant honoring our Lord today.
As a reminder, our contestants will be spelling the many names and titles of Jesus.
That's right. There were 700 of them in the Bible, and each one reveals to us more of his character and how he works in our lives.
What a marvelous Christmas gift we received from the Father 2,000 years ago.
Let's begin the Christmas County Spelling Bee with a review, the ABCs of praise. Listen up as I explain how the bee will work. When your number is called, please step up to the microphone and spell the name you're given. You may ask for a definition, a sentence, a song lyric, or language of origin. If you hear this sound, what do you think it means?
An angel gets his wings?
Wrong Christmas show.
No, if you hear this sound, it means that you have spelled incorrectly. Please step down as you're told what part you'll be playing the pageant. Then go see the wardrobe people and get ready for the pageant.
Remember, the winner will either be featured as Mary or Joseph.
Without any further ado, let's begin this year's annual Christmas County Spelling Bee.
Contestant number 34, Amanda Allen. step up to the microphone.
This is Amanda Allen's second year in the B. She almost made it to the final round last year.
Ready?
R-E-A-D-Y, ready.
No.
N-O, no.
Stop.
S-T-O-P, stop.
Those are not your words. Your word is Lord.
Oh, Lord. L-O-R-D, Lord.
Correct.
Number 17, Kyle Collins.
Kyle Collins is the winner of this year's science fair. I'm sure he has some friends cheering for him today.
Your word is word.
Sentence, please.
Your word is word.
You just said that and I said sentence, please.
That was a sentence. The word is word. Word is the word.
Oh, that word. Word. W-O-R-D. Word.
Correct.
Number 15, Jeffrey Johnson.
Jeffrey Johnson is quite an athlete.
He sure is.
He's on the football, basketball, and soccer teams.
Spell light.
Light. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. L-I-G-H-T. Light.
Correct.
Number 5, Ferris Wheeler.
It's Ferris Wheeler.
Okay, Mr. Wheeler, would you spell El Shaddai?
Are you kidding?
Gotcha, Wheeler.
It's Wheeler.
Just kidding. Your word is savior.
Savior. S-A-V-I-O-R. Savior.
Correct.
Number 9, B. Beasley. Step up to the microphone. Please spell Morning Star.
Notice Bee's bumblebee-inspired outfit. As I recall, she wore something similar last year.
Morning Star. M-O-R-N-I-N-G-S-T-A-R. Morning Star?
Correct.
I know.
Number 11, Brandy Richards. Spell Yahweh.
What? Is that even a word?
Yes, it is. And the language of origin is Hebrew.
Of course. Could I have a definition, please?
Yahweh is an Old Testament name for the Lord God.
Can I just spell God?
You mean may I just spell God?
May I just spell God?
No, we choose the words, Randy. This name is considered to be so sacred that for centuries it was not spoken aloud.
Well, if we're not even supposed to say it, should I really be spelling it?
Your word is Yahweh.
Yahweh. Y-A-H-W-A-Y.
The correct spelling is Y-A-H-W-E-H. Go to the wardrobe. You'll be a wise man tonight.
Well, Pat, we just lost our first finalist because of his misspelling the name Yahweh. Would you have known how to spell this Old Testament name correctly?
No way I could have spelled Yahweh. Our competition will continue.
Number 31, Bella McDowell. Please spell lamb.
Song, please.
Lamb. L-A-M-E. Lamb. Duh.
Bella McDowell. Number 31. The correct spelling of lamb is L-A-M-B. You may go to the wardrobe. You'll be a shepherd lady tonight.
Okay.
That officially ends round one of the spelling bee. Good work, everyone. You may have a short intermission.
What a fantastic job all of our contestants are doing spelling the beautiful names of our Lord. Did you know that no other person in history has as many names and titles?
I think that's because his glory and greatness is beyond description. Coming up next, a special presentation of Angel's Eye View while our contestants are at intermission.
Angel's It's time for the story.
In the beginning...
No, we've already had that story, remember?
Sorry, I forgot.
The time has come for Jesus to be born as a man down there on that planet, Earth.
Really? Now, why would he go there?
To save men, the inhabitants of Earth.
What I've seen of them, they really aren't worse.
Quiet. The Father loves them.
Extraordinary.
Jesus is going down there. May we watch?
I don't see why not.
Where is he going?
To a little village the inhabitants call Bethlehem. It's in a remote part of the Earth called Judea. See, there it is.
Surely there are better places, even on that planet.
He must be born there. Many man years ago, the Father gave his word.
Where is Jesus?
See that small cave cut into the hillside where the animals are? He's with the man and woman. Do you see?
That tiny little baby, not that helpless little baby.
Even I know that if he's to be born as a man, he has to start as a baby. They all do.
It isn't fair. Look at him. He can't walk or talk or anything. Not even as well as that man or woman.
Those must be the people who will care for him. Doesn't that sound strange? People looking after the Son of God.
Listen, Jesus is crying. Quick, can we get him back?
We will, in 33 of those earth years. People will kill him. He'll come back after he dies.
How terrible!
All men die.
Why bother with man? He's an inferior being with terrible habits. I've heard that men murder other men.
I don't understand it either. Why should Jesus have to go down there at all? If the Father wants men here with us angels, why not just make a decree?
Because the Father wants man to have a choice. He wants men to be able to accept or reject the choice of coming here. Sending Jesus is part of the choice.
He has his angels. I still don't understand.
It isn't necessary for you to understand. The Father understands. He created heaven and earth.
Men here?
You'll get used to it. We'll start by completing an assignment. You're about to get a close view of men. We're going down there to find some shepherds, men who tend sheep. We'll tell them Jesus is born in Bethlehem.
Just tell them, and then what?
Nothing. It's up to men from that point. Return here.
And leave Jesus down there with them?
It's the Father's plan to win men.
What if it fails? What if they don't do anything?
Then this birth will be for nothing. The Father only has one plan. It's up to men now.
And we welcome you back for round two of the Christmas County Spelling Bee.
Ms. Foster is about to call the next contestant.
Contestant number 34, Amanda Allen.
I'm sure many of you will remember Amanda from last year. She was so tense that she froze up at the microphone.
Your name to spell is Wonderful Counselor.
Oh no, not again. Breathe, Amanda, breathe.
Again, number 34, Wonderful Counselor.
For those of you who have never actually seen a deer in your headlights, Amanda is doing a pretty good impression of one right now.
Breathe, Amanda, breathe. And now Amanda would probably be asking for a sentence, right? Sentence, please.
Isaiah 9:6 says, and he will be called the Wonderful Counselor.
Amanda? And now I think Amanda should be asking for a song.
Oh, good. This should give Amanda a little time to calm down and get those nerves under control.
And it lets us take some time to praise the Lord for always leading us in wisdom and truth.
I think Amanda Allen went to her wonderful counselor to calm her nerves.
Great job, Amanda.
Number 17, Kyle Collins. Your word is fortress.
Fortress. F-O-R-T-R-E-S-S. Fortress.
Correct.
Number 15, Jeffrey Johnson.
Ladies, please.
That's okay, Judge. I don't mind.
Please spell the name Mighty God.
Mighty God. In a manger bed was born a mighty God. Could you use it in a really cool song?
Here come those adorable cheerleaders coming to share a special song about our mighty God. Let's listen.
Mighty God. M-I-G-H-T-Y-G-O-D. Mighty God.
Correct.
Yay! Number 5. Ferris Wheeler.
It's Wyler. Wyler.
Okay. Number 5. Your name to spell is Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father. Father, where's my father? My father's not here. My father is never here. Father, where art thou, Father? I'm sure Jesus' father would have been his spelling bee. Not my father. Not my father.
Number five. Come back.
It appears that number 5, Ferris Wyler, is a bit distracted.
Perhaps if we go to a song, Mr. Wyler can gather his thoughts.
There's my father. Hi, father. I knew he'd come. Everlasting father. EVERLASTINGFATHER. Everlasting father.
That's a great title for her to spell.
Why do you say that?
Because Bee Beasley is known for staying as busy as a bee all the time, but especially around Christmas time.
Well, the girls are coming to share a special Christmas song about our Prince of Peace. Let's listen.
Peace, King of Peace, you stand fast, love is all I need.
Prince of Peace. P-R-I-N-C-O-F-P-A-C-E. Prince of Peace.
Your mistake was spelling too quickly. The correct spelling of Prince of Peace is P-R-I-N-C-E-O-F-P-E-A-C-E. Thank you for participating. You may go to the wardrobe. You'll be an angel tonight.
I guess it's bye-bye to Beatrice B. Beasley. The B just got buzzed.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are officially entering our third and final round of the Christmas County Spelling Bee.
Number 34, Amanda Allen. Spell Jehovah. Oh, here we go again. Judge, may we have a sentence, please?
I will trust and not be afraid, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song.
Hey, that's my favorite verse, Isaiah 12, 2. And I will not be afraid. Jehovah, J-E-H-O-V-A-H, Jehovah.
Correct.
Number 17, Kyle Collins. Please spell the name Restorer.
Restorer. R-E-S-T-O-R-E. Restorer.
I'm sorry, number 17. There's a more R at the end of Restorer. You may go to the wardrobe. You'll be a shepherd tonight.
Mr. Collins is out of the B. Now we are down to three.
Number 15, Jeffrey Johnson. Please spell the name mediator.
Can I have a definition, please?
A person who intervenes in a dispute to find an agreement.
So, kind of like a referee, right?
Yes, Jeffrey, it is like a referee.
Thank you. Referee. R-E-F-E-R-E-E. Referee.
I'm sorry. I thought it was more appropriate for Jeffrey if I blow my whistle. Young man, here where is mediator, not referee.
No, dude.
I'm sorry, dude. You're out of the B.
Can I talk to a mediator, please?
Decision of the referee. I mean the judge. It's final.
Well, thought I'd try. Bye for now.
Go to the wardrobe. You'll be a wise man tonight.
Then there were two. Will we have a Mary winner?
Or a Joseph winner tonight. Let's see.
Number 5, Ferris Wheeler, not Wheeler. Please spell the name Deliverer.
Deliverer. D-E-L-I-V-E-R-E-R. Deliverer.
Correct. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a tie. According to the rules of the Christmas County Spelling Bee, there are two contestants left. They're both to spell the same word by writing it down. Now please, take out your pens and move to separate sides of the platform.
Contestants, please write down the correct spelling of Nazarene.
And it was fulfilled what was said of the prophets, and he will be called Nazarene. Matthew 2:23. Contestants, may I see your answers, please?
Nazarene.
You're both correct. Now take your pens and spell your final word.
Your final word, please spell the name Emmanuel.
Tension is high in Town Hall. Let's give them some additional time to think as we sing to Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
Thank you.
May I see your answers, please?
It looks like we've got a winner. Amanda spelled it correctly. I-M-M-A-N-U-E-L.
No, Farrah spelled it correctly. E-M-M-A-N-U-E-L.
Order. Order the town hall. I said order! Looks like we have a Mary and a Joseph winner. You are both correct. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Amanda and Ferris. Great job. Make your way quickly to the wardrobe and get your costume on. The Christmas pageant has been cast and we are just moments away. Can I have the manger set? Can I have the stage crew bring out our manger set, please?
If I may, I would just like to add a personal thank you to all of our contestants. Like many of you, I have learned so much about our Lord Jesus today as we have looked at his many names.
That's correct. He truly is our wonderful counselor, our mighty God, and so incredibly much more. Emmanuel, our God has been with us ever since that wonderful holy night in the manger bed.
Let's worship and praise our Savior and Lord, Jesus, the name above all names.
Thank you.
This Christmas, we want you to know that Jesus is your Savior and Lord. The Bible says he has written your name on the palm of his mighty hand.
Let me ask you this, boys and girls, how do you spell love?
J-E-S-U-S, Jesus!
For unto us a child is born.
Unto us a son is given.
And the government will be upon his shoulders.
And his name will be called
Wonderful
Counselor, the Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, Jesus, the name above all names.
Does this one work? I wasn't sure because it said spare, and I figured Kathy Arnold left it for me. So, you are all aware none of this just happens. Boy, have we had volunteers and people working behind the scenes right back there in the sound booth. Please help me thank Jim Hall, Rod Mays, Andrew Platt, and Jordan Heath. Greenview Church for this incredible building and facility and all that we have used and borrowed and broken and had to be fixed again of yours. Our stage setup, undeniably, Guy Edwards and Super Dave. We were really proud that you got to hear the debut of New Horizon Christian School beginner band Bill Reynolds. Are you still in here? There he is. All these little props you saw, we want to thank Patty Flick. As a matter of fact, today she was putting costumes still together. So where is Patty Flick? Right there. And the eighth grade always thinks they're going to get off easy because they got to practice with the program. Well, they weren't figuring on Mrs. Kenda Hyde, our drama coach. Kenda. Okay, the little people running around here in black made all of this transition pretty smoothly. Help me thank Austin, Camila, Alexis, and Sammy. There they are. Okay, kindergarten, first grade, stand up. Thank you for your scripture verses. And second grade for your ABCs of praise. And did we ever have fun with our third and fourth grade cheerleaders? And then we had those counselors. You don't know how much they had to counsel me to help me remember their part. So our third and fourth grade boys. And then did you see yourself in the faces of our fifth and sixth grade shopper girls? Stand up, girls. Okay, you've been waiting to do this. The Everlasting Fathers. And then I want you to help me thank our cast. Judge Thomas Evan Bryant, step forward. Our pronouncer, Miss Foster, Anna Mullins. Check, Vanna Black, Haley Hampton, and Cade Cole. Ferris Weiler, not Wheeler, Ray Niederhofer. Kyle Collins, Zachary Schwartz. Okay, girls, one more time. Jeffrey Johnson, Devin Starr. Our angel and Beatrice B. Beasley, Stacy Harris. Bella McDowell, who got thrown out by the whole staff and crew, Camila Gans. One of the all-time stars of our show, Randy Richards, Joe Lipsy. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise God, this was just great. Oh no, our other champion. You know what? I must have folded my paper too soon, but I sure don't want to forget Mary, Amanda Allen, the deer in the headlights, Jacqueline Grimes.
I have to say it again, it was an amazing evening. You know, if you don't take anything away from this time tonight other than seeing your darling kids and your great young people here and your gratitude for your children being able to attend a Christian school, take the message of Jesus Christ with you. Tonight, these kids had a wonderful time. They did a great job with their singing, their cheerleaders, our old men, our counselors, and, you know, all of our kids. But they gave you a message. They gave you a message of hope and a message of eternal life. If tonight you have never, ever yielded your life to Jesus Christ and asked him to be the Lord of you, of who you are, and ask him to forgive you of your sins, it's not hard. The word tells us that we have to confess and believe that he is the risen, Son of God. He is the Christ. And believe in our hearts that we are saved. You know, he's coming back one of these days, not as a baby, not as a little baby. He's going to be coming back as the mighty king. And I'm looking forward to him. But the only way I can look forward to him is because of Jesus Christ. So if you've never, ever accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, tonight is the night of salvation. Tonight is the night of salvation. Just confess, you know, Lord, I need you. I need you. I ask that you forgive me of my sins and come and live in my life. And that I am able to live with you and live for you. It's not hard. We're so thankful you're here. If you want to stick around and talk to someone about the condition of your soul, that's great. If not, I pray that the Holy Spirit will continue to deal with you. Thank you again. We're going to be closed out in prayer by Beth Tate. And we just want to thank you again for coming and supporting the school.
Well, it's a Christmas miracle that Mrs. Tate is not crying at the end of the Christmas program. But pray with me, please. God, thank you, thank you, thank you for what a wonderful night this has been. Just so many amazing ways that you bless us. Thank you for all these people, the parents, the grandparents, aunts, uncles, everybody who supports the school and the staff. And thank you for these wonderful students. And we do truly pray that somebody was drawn closer to you, has come to know you through this program. Again, thank you for blessing us. We ask that you continue to bless us, help us to get home safe tonight and back again tomorrow. In Jesus' name I pray.